I need to know how to fix Xbox One Kinect not turning on. This is frustrating, given how much I use it for.
It has to be plugged in to turn on.
It is plugged in.
Sometimes you have to unplug it and plug it back in for the console to recognize it.
Ah, the hard reboot solution.
A hard reset can fix it temporarily. If you have to keep resetting the console and Kinect, run a software update, since the last patch may have messed it up.
I've already tried power cycling.
Hold down the power button on the console until it turns orange, let it all power down, unplug the Kinect, then reconnect the Kinect. If it does not come back on after plugging it in, reboot the console.
Of course there's a reboot in there.
Another thing to check is that the console knows that the Kinect is supposed to be on. Go to Menu, Settings, Kinect, and make sure Kinect On is picked.
I wonder if it is a hardware issue or a software issue.
After you plug the Kinect back in, if you're still at the Settings Kinect screen, watch it and see if it recognizes the sensor after 10 seconds or so.
What if it doesn't?
You can run updates.
You already told me to update the console.
You can also update the device by going to Menu, Home, Settings Kinect On, and seeing if it tells you to update the device. It should update the device automatically, and let you see the status on that screen.
Assuming it didn't update automatically along with all the other updates.
It cannot update the device if it is not connected to the console while the updates run, and it won't update the Kinect if the device isn't recognized as plugged in.
I saw a notice that it does not have power for the Kinect.
If you get a no power notice, you may need a new Kinect.
Technically, a new working Kinect solves my problem with the malfunctioning existing one.
If it is not recognizing the Kinect sensor though, the first thing to check is that you put its cable into the correct Kinect sensor port. Then go to the Kinect screen in the Settings menu and see if it comes up.
And if it does not?
You can try the updates and reboots, but contacting the Microsoft Online Service Center is the best bet.
Sure, and I'll have already run through half their tech support script of reboot and update already.